So if you went out to get a loan to get a car or a house, you'd be expecting to pay interest, wouldn't you? I mean, after all, you're using the bank's money. Now, if the tables were turned and you are the bank and somebody applied to borrow your money, I mean, you'd be charging them interest, correct? So what if I told you that most people that get a large tax return are actually giving out an interest-free loan every year to their favorite family member? And how much interest did you charge that family member? Zero. You actually did it for free. So who'd you give out a zero interest-free loan to? Your favorite uncle? Uncle Sam. See, that's what happens when you think getting a large tax return is actually getting over on the government. The government actually got over on you. How? I'll explain in this episode of the 7-Figure Squad. So grab your notes, let's get money, because we're starting in 3, 2, 1. Everybody, Money Smart Guy Matt Cipolla here, hailing to you for the Money Smart Movement Team headquarters of the 7-Figure Squad. Guys, I'm excited for you. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you follow me on YouTube, hit subscribe. If you follow me on Instagram, find Money Smart Guy too as well. By the way, we are on a journey to 15,000 subs. So let me sweeten the pot. When we cross over 10,000 subs, we gave over a custom pair of Jordans. And they were in their logo, they were in their colors, they were in their design. So what am I do this time around to 15,000 subs? Let me sweeten the pot some more. So when we cross 15,000 subs, I'm gonna choose a subscriber that's constantly engaging, constantly dropping comments, constantly dropping their thoughts. I'm gonna get you a pair of custom Jordans in your company name and your logo and your colors that you want. And in addition to that, guess what? We just had Phil Heath at our last event, Mr. 7-time Mr. Olympia bodybuilder. And he signed a shirt for us right here, Mr. Olympia 7-time, et cetera, et cetera. So therefore, from him, from my office to you, we're gonna add this to the pot. Once you cross over 15,000 subs, to those of you who help us build this community of the 7-Figure Squad. All right, so let's get into it. I remember when I was in the Marine Corps and we were just itching to get our W-2s in the mail. I mean, we're scoping out our mail. Mail call, man, we're looking forward to it, because we want to make sure we go down to the local H&R Block, the local Jackson Hewitt, the local person that files their income taxes to make sure we get our bonus check at the beginning of the year, because we blew all our money in the previous year. And we got credit card debt from the holidays. So we're looking forward to that bigger fat check, that bonus check, to get ahead in the year coming forward. I mean, how many of you right now are actually scoping out your mailbox? How many of you guys are scoping out, make sure the postal worker, the postal carrier is coming down, and as soon as he comes in, you're checking the mail as soon as he gets there, so therefore you can file your W-2 and get your tax return back as well. You know what's worse? Are the people that are actually filing their taxes and they're paying additional fees to get their tax money back sooner, faster, and earlier. They're paying more money to get their own money back. Let me explain. The fact of the matter is, getting over an Uncle Sam is not through getting a large tax return. You might be surprised that your tax refund is just simply just that, a refund of your own money. It means that you overpaid your tax obligation to the government, to the federal government. It means you overpaid your tax obligation for that year, and all you're doing is getting a zero interest free loan from the government using your money for whatever they wanted to use it for back to you at 0% interest. I mean, does that sound like a good deal to you?
It was all bullshit.
If so, then shoot, drop your name and information below. I want to borrow money from you. You lend money to me, I go out and invest it, I make money with it, and I give it back to you using your money for 12 months with zero interest. All right, now that sound like a good deal or what? So let's take a look at a typical 1040. So here inside the 1040, you file your wages, your salary, all those things on page 1. But if you go to page 2, you go to line 16, and that's what exactly tells you what you owe in taxes. That's what you owe with your deductions, with you having a wife, you having a kid, you having a house, et cetera, et cetera. That's what you owe in tax for that year. Now, if you go to line 19, this is the amount of taxes you actually paid from your salary, from your paycheck, from your employer. And if you go down to line 20, this is the amount you overpaid. This is the money that Uncle Sam will refund you back if you want to, because you overpaid your taxes that year. I mean, some of you guys might be suffering from a condition called intoxication. What do I mean by intoxication? Here's what intoxication means. It means it's a euphoria at getting a tax refund, which lasts until you realize it's only your own money that you're getting back. I mean, President Trump, what do you think about that?
It was all bullshit.
Now, if there's one thing that millionaires and wealthy individuals understand is that taxes are probably one of the most biggest expenses they experience in their entire lifetime. So therefore, finding ways to minimize what one pays in taxes could mean tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, or in some cases, millions of dollars over a lifetime back in your pocket. Now, millionaires and wealthy individuals understand there's some basic tax loopholes to minimize their overall tax bill. In a previous episode, some misconceptions of millionaires, my CEO and mentor, Patrick McDavid, said, listen, you gotta look at the tax system, you gotta look at the tax laws as an incentive plan for you to make money in this country.
America's comp structure is set up to benefit entrepreneurs, period. It is set up to benefit entrepreneurs. A different country who has an 80% tax or a communism or socialism, it is set up to produce employees who follow order. Very simple. America's comp plan tells you, hey, Matt, if you're willing to risk your entire savings to go start your own business, work 80 hours a week for 5 to 10 years, you're willing to sacrifice that for 10 years in the likelihood of maybe making millions of dollars and creating a lot of jobs. If you're willing to take that kind of a risk, guess what? I'm willing to give you the best compensation structure, which is lower taxes.
So to keep things easy, by putting your money in certain accounts, investing in businesses, even spending money through a business can lower your overall tax obligation to the federal government. In fact, the government might even subsidize some things that you like to do for fun. Now for some of you, before I jump into the top five ways that millionaires look at expenses and taxes, is go to the IRS withholding estimator. It's on the IRS's website. See, there's a specific calculator there that you can actually adjust what your employer takes from your taxes, that you can adjust what they take from your paycheck. It's called the W-4 withholding calculator. Go check it out, plug in information, grab your W-2, grab your last paycheck, plug the information in, and who knows, might be able to fill out your W-4 a little differently. So therefore, instead of waiting till the end of the year to get a big tax refund, you're gonna get that additional income that you're already earning back to you, not at the end of the year, but throughout the year, every paycheck that you're working. Now, before I share with you these five different ways, make sure you consult with your tax advisor, your CPA, your tax professional on the validation of what you can write off on your taxes. I'm just exposing and making you aware that these certain tax laws exist, so therefore you can take advantage of it. But make sure you disclose, because I am not a CPA, I'm not a tax professional, so make sure you check with yours. So here's five ways that millionaires look at taxes differently. Number one, owning a business. Now, you may not be a full-time entrepreneur. I believe the wording in the IRS says that as long as you're establishing a form of trade or business, the whole other side of the tax law is opened up to you. See, in the words of Sandy Bakken, who wrote the book, Lower Your Taxes Big Time, he mentions there's two sets of tax laws. Number one, for the uninformed, and number two, for the informed. You can choose in this year which side of tax law you wanna be on. But number one, let's say you're established a business. Millionaires and wealthy individuals know that the chance for them to be wealthy and to be financially free and successful is through business ownership. Why? The government is actually assisting and incentivizing them to do so. What am I talking about? So let's give an example. Let's say as a business owner, you make $1 million in revenue. You have a business, you're selling goods and services, real estate, you're selling stuff on Amazon. Now you see, to the typical employee, the first thing that gets taken out of the paycheck is taxes. You got Social Security tax, you got FICA, you got all those deductions from your gross pay, then down to your net pay. That's for the typical employee that's working for a boss. However, as an entrepreneur establishing a business, you can actually deduct things like meals, like travel, like cars, furniture, computers, your internet, your Wi-Fi, your cable, and on and on and on through your business. So in other words, in this example, if you have $200,000 of expenses to actually run that type of business, you're not getting taxed at $1 million because you can write off $200,000 of expenses on your taxes. So instead of getting taxed on $1 million minus the $200,000 of expenses to run your business, you're actually gonna get taxed at a lower income level, which in this case is $800,000. So if you're gonna pay 25% in income taxes, do you wanna pay 25% on $1 million or do you wanna pay 25% on $800,000? You see what I mean? Now, most people think that owning a business, you gotta be sophisticated, you gotta have these degrees, you gotta have a fancy pedigree, you have to have a high credit score and a lot of money to get it started. That is far from the truth. For example, I was a broke Marine with like a 400 credit score. I was a single dad and I was able to start a business with less than $500 and years later became a multimillionaire. How? Because somebody educated me on entrepreneurship and owning a business. So in other words, even if you have a job, as long as you have a side business, not a side job, not a second job, but if you have a side business, then you can start writing off some of these expenses on your taxes because you're a bona fide entrepreneur. Now, I'm gonna share number two and number three at the same time, which is earning money from capital gains or dividends. Now, capital gains is a profit you make from an investment. Sure, there's short-term capital gains and long-term capital gains. Short-term meaning that you bought an investment, bought some stock, bought an asset, and you sold it for a profit less than a year, and you're taxed at a short-term capital gains rate. Versus the long-term capital gains rate, which is you bought an investment, same scenario, but you held it for over 12 months. Then you're taxed at the long-term capital gains rate. Big difference. Because the difference is taking a long-term capital gains tax rate could be the difference of paying 37% on taxes versus 20% in taxes. What would you rather pay? Because that is a 17% difference on taking long-term capital gains tax. Because what wealthy people understand is that it's one thing to make money, but it's another thing to keep a majority of it. Now, dividends is money paid to investors from the profit of a company. Like long-term capital gains, dividends are taxes based on your taxable income and can be anywhere from 0 to 20% rate depending on your income. In order to benefit from tax advantages of dividends, the dividends needs to meet the requirements of a qualified dividend to be taxed at these lower rates. So let me explain. There's three criteria to explain what a qualified dividend is. Number one, first, they must be paid by either a domestic or a US-based company or a foreign one that meets certain requirements. Number two, the company's payouts must not be on the IRS list of dividends considered to be unqualified. And number three, there is a holding period. What is that holding period? The payee must own the stock for a minimum of roughly 60 days for common stock and 90 days for preferred stock. Now, I know that's a lot of jargon held at you, right? I know, I totally get it. Listen, but if you want to raise your money game, this is the type of language you got to learn how to start speaking. This is the type of language that separates the rich getting richer and the multicultural middle class and the poor getting poorer. So I'm glad you're watching this episode until now. Let me give you a most recent example of somebody that earns capital gains and dividends versus somebody that has wages and salaries. Who am I talking about? Mitt Romney filed his tax returns and submitted for public disclosure of how he earns his money. Well, this is his tax refund writing. Right, this is not your typical person get a 1, 2, 3-page tax refund. This is a guy that's a multi-millionaire, deca-millionaire at that. Now, anybody can find Mitt Romney's tax returns on the internet. You know, he's a senator. Matter of fact, he was the one who voted against Donald Trump and very few Republicans to vote Donald Trump to be impeached from the Republican side of things. But anyway, make a long story short, he submitted his tax refunds for the public to see. And here's the thing about tax returns. It tells you a story. The numbers lead a trail to how people make money, especially a deca-millionaire. So I'm looking at Mitt Romney's tax returns. I'm just taking a simple look at the first few pages of his tax return. I noticed right away, number one, on line number seven, he makes zero money from wages and salaries. What is the difference? See, let me show you a table of the difference between being taxed on wages and salaries versus being taxed on capital gains and dividends. Do you see the difference? Huge difference. Either you get taxed on wages at a higher rate or you get taxed on capital gains and dividends at a much lower rate. So I'm looking at this thing. What is the government actually getting me to do? Is the government saying, hey, just collect a paycheck and work for somebody? Or is the government actually incentivizing people to earn money on investing and building businesses and investing in other businesses? See, that's what Mitt Romney has done practically entire lifetime. Because you look at line number 8 and line number 9, he makes money through taxable interest. He makes money through ordinary dividends. You see what I'm talking about? Number two, number three, that's how he's making his money. And then you go down to line number 13, close to $13 million of income he's making from what? Capital gains. See, that's how the rich make money. Man, if you combine that all together, he's making over $21 million of income in the United States. Now, did this happen to Mitt Romney and his wife overnight? Of course not. This is something he's done his entire life. And we're just now seeing the back end of those decisions. See, for those of you watching this video right now, you can get started in your 20s and 30s, or some of you that even in your 40s and 50s and 60s, it's not too late to start. You just gotta get started now. Start planting your financial flag so therefore you can invest in businesses, you can grow your own business, you can invest in companies, and you start earning income through what? Not wages and salaries, but you can start earning income through dividends and capital gains. See, that's how the millionaires become multimillionaires, and you can too. Number four. Millionaires buy lots of life insurance. What? Life insurance? Don't they have a lot of money to pass on to the heirs anyway? No, no, no. They use the life insurance industry for the tax shelter and tax haven it creates. See, there's two major styles of life insurance. Number one, cheap vanilla insurance, which is the cheapest premium for the largest amount of death benefit. And for most cases, the only time you get that money is when you pass away. But you see, wealthy people, they put their money inside what they call permanent life insurance. And of course, there's many different types of permanent insurance, from whole life to universal life to index universal life to variable universal life. There's many different variations, second to die life, joint life. There's many different variations of life insurance, but this is the permanent side of the life insurance world, where there's two major tax laws that go into work for them, which is Section 101A, which says money that's inside of the life insurance policy is transferred tax-free to the beneficiary, and then Section 7702, which says under the IRS code, money can grow inside a life insurance policy and can be withdrawn without paying a dime in tax if it's taken out with specific guidelines. So who educates people about those specific guidelines? Tax professionals and insurance professionals educate the wealthy on how to set up their money properly. Is this established overnight? Of course not. It's done over a period of time. See, most millionaires use life insurance as a big safety net or a big financial foundation just in case things go bad. And trust me, they do. I'm not gonna get too much involved into it. You need to check with not only your tax professional, but also your insurance professional, because money inside permanent life insurance policy is the only financial vehicle that can grow your money tax-free, can be withdrawn tax-free, and blossoms in value to the next generation, next beneficiary, income tax-free. That's a triple tax advantage, tax-free way to get your money to grow. And that's the reason, again, why the millionaires become millionaires and why the wealthy become wealthier. Last but not least, number five, deducting depreciating assets. You see, a couple weeks ago, I purchased a Rolls Royce. What a lot of people understand is I'm not buying this Rolls Royce like most people buy a Rolls Royce. I bought the Rolls Royce through my company. I bought the Rolls Royce, so therefore I can depreciate it over a five-year period. See, what a lot of people don't understand, that based on current tax laws, certain things that you purchase to operate your business can be deducted as these things lose value. What am I talking about? Car, furniture, machinery, computers, software, real estate, and in my case, a Rolls Royce. To view what you can deduct over certain timeframes, check out this resource so therefore you can see what can actually be deducted over certain timeframes. Taking advantage of these depreciating assets and deducting them on their taxes is a major loophole, which is ethical and legal, provided by the IRS, so therefore people can start growing their wealth. So again, let me remind you, these five things here, I'm not a CPA, I'm not a tax professional. All I know is I have these conversations at length with the people that's in my corner helping me rule my kingdom to make sure I win the money game. And I'm encouraging you to do the same too as well. You need to build a team around you that advises you and guides you so therefore you can make moves to raise and improve your money game. A suggested book for you guys to check out and make sure you read and consume is this book called Lower Your Taxes Big Time, written by Sandy Botkin, who's not only a CPA, but also an attorney who used to train IRS agents to do their job. So in a future episode, I'm gonna be talking about how I bought this Rolls Royce through my company, how I'm depreciating it, and how my net payment on this on a monthly basis is less than a cup of coffee going to Starbucks on a monthly basis. So please be sure, if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, The Seven Figure Squad. Make sure you click subscribe, hit the bell to be alerted next time we upload our next episode. I'm also found on Instagram. Make sure you follow me on Instagram at MoneySmartGuy and The Seven Figure Squad. Make sure you follow me there too as well, so you can see behind the scenes what we do on a daily basis in helping create businesses, helping create the next generation of entrepreneurs inside the insurance industry. With that being said, I'd love to know your thoughts. I'd love to know your feedback. I'd love to know whether or not you were intoxicated, you find yourself to be intoxicated. Drop them in the comment section below and make sure you subscribe, because hey, I'm giving out a free pair of custom Jordans to a engaged subscriber in our community, as well as a signed t-shirt from Mr. 7-time Mr. Olympia, Phil Heath, from me, from us to you. I appreciate you guys tuning in and watching this episode. I'm your Money Smart Guy, Matt Zappala, and until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.